नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स फ्रॉम ऑल फील्ड्स, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग फॉर वन एंड ऑल। लेट मी टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट फर्दर मोर by explaining the Yoga Shastra in depth. The reason for telling this as a Yoga Shastra, if you people remember, or one who has been following my videos for in YouTube, I was speaking about yoga in cross reference to Gayatri Mantra. Most of us think whatever that we are practicing at a subtle level, subtler level, that is a lower level, with regards to asanas or whatever it is, it's the base level where you as an individual try to synchronize yourself with the universal creation, understanding the deeper aspect of it by questioning who am I, what am I, why am I on this earth, why am I being born, what is my purpose, and what is the goal and aim of my existence as an individual. When I say my, it is the universe that created you. It could be me as Naradla Ramachandra or some XYZ with a name. However, here one needs to understand, when a soul is created, he or she is embodied or captivated in one body. It should have some name, right? So they name some XYZ. For example, my name is Naradla Ramachandra. But once I as a soul, beyond the cosmic energy level, cosmic universe, will not have any name as such. So here, once you are coming down to earth from the mother's womb, after the Lingodbhava Kala, wherein it happens due to the male and female's cross section, zygote is formed in the female's fetus, it comes out as a full body. It could be he, it could be she. Now, I always was speaking about universal laws and and their principles that are to be followed by an individual, whether it is he or she or the third gender, or it could be anything. Now, these mantras, tantras make an individual to get to a level which more or less takes you to the level of understanding yourself as an individual. It is not at all gender based. Let's try understanding this concept first, then I will get to the other concept. Yoga. Yo plus ga. Yo means space, ga means time. As an individual, once you are getting elevated to the earth, or you come down to the earth, what happens is you will be between space and time as an individual. This is one very important point which one needs to understand. That is one reason why yoga is a primary step which has mudras and other asanas that helps an individual to get elevated to the level of understanding who am I, what am I, why am I on this earth, what is the purpose, and what is the end goal, what is the end result. It is for the individual to program or realign or restructure or re-engineer his or her mind from the conscious or subconscious mind. For this purpose of the Navanidha Bhaktis, one is meditation, one is yajna, other is yajna, homas, and then mantra japa, tantra yoga, and then mantra at the highest level. For this purpose, Gayatri mantra is one of the mantra which culminates whole of this concept of existence of universe or existence of yourself as an individual. It's like factors and cofactors that govern you or that lead you to the to that level to understand that core concept. For a dancer or the musician or one who is practicing highest level of yoga would be able to understand. Here, let me clarify on this. Let's not get into the shortcuts. I have seen quite a few talking about Sahaja Yoga, etc., etc., etc. For me, that's a pure nonsense, because one needs to go through the grind of understanding himself or herself with a long practice. Whatever realization or self-realization that one wants, it comes only through patience, perseverance, and thorough penance. It does not happen overnight or within 30 minutes or 1 hour or whatever it is. This I am making it very clear for the viewers, though I'm sorry, but I have seen people talking about it. Let's not get into that misconception. Now, Om Bhur Bhuva Suvaha Tat Sat Vitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhi Mahi Yonah Prachodayat. The last word Prachodayat is like cleansing your whole of your body. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. And this is the practical importance of chanting the mantra. When you are chanting the mantra, that's the reason why you need to enunciate and pronounce those words in a systematic way, and it has certain pattern. However, as a part of note and disclaimer to the audience or to the individuals who are watching my video, I am also a human being. I may commit mistake when pronouncing or enunciating. Please do correct me, but still I am trying to get this knowledge across the people, specifically for the one who is a classical dancer, the one who is aspiring to be a classical dancer or musician, and one who is trying to establish himself in yoga or tantra or mantra domains. One needs to understand this. As I was trying to explain Sahasrara, Agya, Vishuddhi, Anahata, Manipura, Swadhisthana, Mooladhara, in cross reference to Sahasrara being Shiva, Agnya Chakra being Adi Shakti, Vishuddhi being Vishnu, Anahata being Manashakti, Manashakti, Manasashakti, Manipura, Kartikeya, Swadhisthana, Brahma, Mooladhara, Ganesha. If you really see, we have Brahma Granthi, which is nothing but Swadhisthana, Vishnu Granthi, nothing but Vishuddhi Chakra. Sorry about that. Rudra Granthi, that is Shiva, being Sahasrara. Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Talatala, Rasatala, Mahatala, Patala. That is below your navel part. When we look at, if we look at, it's like, it is like from here, it starts from here and goes to your knees, that is this legs here till your toes. And Bhurloka, Bhuvarloka, Suvarloka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Satyaloka, below your, beyond your Sahasrara. That means it goes above this. Once you get that self-realization point, you tend to get above this. That is a reason why Gayatri Mantra is further extension to yoga. Yoga or टाइम एंड स्पेस ट्रैवल यो प्लस गा. हियर टाइम एंड स्पेस इज बिकॉज देयर यू गेट सम टाइम आउट ऑफ इट वेर इन यू एज एन इंडिविजुअल विल अंडरस्टैंड हु एम आई, वाई एम आई, वॉट एम आई, वॉट इज द पर्पस, वाई एम आई ऑन दिस अर्थ. नाउ वन मे क्वेश्चन मी, वाई आर वी रियली लुकिंग एट दिस 3 × 7 21 चक्रास. These are considered as chakras. Understand this. We take only 7 chakras, that is Shat chakras, starting from Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddhi, Agya, and Sahasrara. We only know that, but when a dancer dances, it starts from your toes and then gets to your this level where the energy starts traveling from toes and then gets to this Mooladhara. This is what is Mooladhara. And then talking about the navel part, here is the where the energy gets blasted out. The moment it gets blasted out, it goes to this part, this chest part, and then it travels all the way to this Arya chakra. This Arya chakra here, the energy is, the highest level of energy is released, and one needs to control over that. Once this energy level, which is having what, where the enormous energy is released, it goes to this level, that is Sahasrara. After this, the moment this person goes, he or she goes to this level, then it goes to the highest level. That is nothing but Bhurloka, Bhuvarloka, Swarloka, Suvarloka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Satyaloka. So Gayatri Mantra, if we really practice day in and day out, and we understand every bit of it, starting from toe to your navel, from navel to your head, from the head above head, if you start understanding, believe me, you will reach to the highest level of energy levels. Once this exercise is done, this is what is called Prachodayat. Om Bhur Bhuvas Suvah Tat Sat Vitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya. Devasya, here we are talking about Deva. Devasya means here we are trying to pacify, or we are trying to satisfy the universal gods who are there in the universe, namely Shiva, Adishakti, Vishnu, Manashakti, Kartikeya, Brahma, and Ganesha. And most importantly, here we will be touching upon, as an individual, Brahma Granthi, Vishnu Granthi, and Rudra Granthi. Brahma is nothing but creation, creator of the universe. And Vishnu is the one who beautifies and who tries to create the universe in a very beautiful way. Sorry about that. Vishnu beautifies and he entices people to understand the beauty of the nature. And Shiva is the Rudrakriti, wherein you tend to understand the creation and destruction of the universe also happens. Now, coming to this point, till now we have understood this. Now, if we really look at the Gayatri Mantra, all of these characters, whatever that you are looking at, Brahma Granthi, Rudra Granthi, Vishnu Granthi, these characters will be there in the three aspect. Three aspect or the females. Female aspect. When I say female, they are considered to be three. Three means Sat plus Trayam. Trayam means here Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara. Here is where Granthis also start forming. This is just my perception. This is the way I could understand. I may be right, I may be wrong, but it's a kind request as a part of note and disclaimer. In case if there is any sort of correction, please do let me know on the comments. Please, it's a request. I am also a human being. I may commit mistake. In my explanation, I may be right or wrong. Okay. Now, this is one part of it. Now, let's get to the next part of it. Once we have mastered on this and we are able to pacify or we have got to that highest realm, highest stage, rather I can put it across. Here there are various knowledge that needs to be understood by an individual, whether he or she or the third gender or anyone for that matter. Shastra Kripa, Guru Kripa, Atma Kripa and Ishwara Kripa. In Shastra Kripa, it talks about Shastras, wherein you tend to win over your inner soul. That is what is called Atman. Atman in the sense, this Atma talks about the, this Atman gets connected with the Jivatman. Atman plus Jivatman equal to Paramatman. Parama Atman. This is the state where if one reaches, it is what is called Paramahamsa state. Paramahamsa state. Or Paramahamsoham. Soham state. Wherein you will be in this world, but you stay detached. You will have that kind of understanding. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. Specifically for the classical dancers or the musicians or the musicologists, when he or she is practicing swaras, saptaswaras, there are certain vibrations that happen and those changes happen. It's like they change whole of the hormonal, the kind of hormonal changes start happening, genetic changes happen and whatnot, every change in a more positive way. Though this was practiced by rishis and munis in the medieval times, today unfortunately we do not have, and due to pandemic attack the energy this positive energy cannot be given out on the stage because virus etc is all this limitations are there. So now we can rely only on the vibrations, sound vibrations. The science of sound comes into picture. At the same time, we need to understand one more word over here. Hum Fat Swaha. Hum Om. तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्. Here if you see who sound comes, HU. I should thank a gentleman who gave this knowledge, who taught me and who made me understand that this sound gives that highest energy level or activates whole of the body. My thanks to you, sir. Now, who sound is very important sound. Understand this. Om. Who sound is coming? Bhur. Bhuva Suvaha Tatsa Vitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyo Yonap Prachodayat. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen, to the core. Now, if we really see that 3 into 7, 21. We have 21 what you call chakras that are getting activated. Apart from these usage of elbows or your knees or your toes here, you do right, and we tend to move our hands, we tend to use our fingers, we have all of these happening. So we have around 36 chakras that automatically get activated during the activity that happens during the dance performance. And this is the very prime, you know, importance or the fact that one needs to understand, ladies and gentlemen. And Natya Shastra talks about 36 chapters, but it is transcribed from whole of these 36 tattvas which I am talking about. Thus, key factors or pointers for understanding the yoga tattva or the travel of the individual in time and space is understanding of Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddhi, Agya and Sahasrara Chakra. That will be there again between this part to this part. And below this we have Atala,
वितल सुतल
तलातल रसातल महातल पाताल एंड बियॉन्ड दिस सहस्रारा यू हैव भूवरलोक भूर्लोक स्वरलोक महर्लोक जनलोक तपोलोक सत्यलोक. These are the pointers which one needs to understand, and apart from these, the other pointers that one needs to understand, it is not only for classical dancers, musicians, and it is useful for the individuals as well who are getting into so-called yoga practice or meditational practice or whatever practices or ritualistic practices in a positive way. Shastra Krupa, Guru Krupa, Atma Krupa, Shiva Krupa. Atma Krupa automatically happens and Guru's Krupa also will be there, and at the same time you will have that Shastra's knowledge also coming. Thus I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Have a nice day ahead. Understand these concepts. If you are following this on a regular day-to-day basis, if you are practicing whatever that has been told, believe me, you will reach to the highest realms. And it does not happen overnight. I am telling you again and again. Please do not get carried away with the, you know, fake gurus who say that we will give you self-realization in half an hour's time, one day's time, 1 month's time, 3 months' time, 2 months' time. That does not stay. Understand this. Have a nice day ahead. And in case if you feel I have spoken anything wrong, as a part of note and disclaimer, while pronouncing or enunciating the Gayatri Mantra or an explanation, please do let me know. At the same time, please do pass on the comments, whatever questions that you have. Stay blessed, have a blissful life, have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Thus I conclude this video. Have a nice day ahead.